Ladies and gentlemen, we're back. It's Happy Hour with Marcus, season two. We're approaching the end of season two, but before I close out season two, I had to get my good friend, Danny Cutler, in the building. Radio DJ extraordinaire.
Thank you.
Absolutely. Representing KWSS 93.9. Yes. You might have heard This Modern on there once or twice. Once or twice, we've made an appearance. Thank you for being here with us.
Thank you for having me. Absolutely. The tables have turned.
I'm interviewing Danny today because I want to get to know more about woman, the legend that is Danny Cutler. Now, today, we've got a special beverage. I forget what it's called already. It's called a Citrus Sunrise.
Ooh.
Courtesy of Ciroc. We have been all over this summer citrus in hopes that P. Diddy will recognize us one day. He has not yet. But that's okay. P.
It'll
Diddy,
happen.
This is good stuff. Love to get a bunch of it. Step number one, the vodka. Now, 3 ounces,
okay.
An ounce and a half for each of us. I'm going to open this.
Oh, yes.
And let's get to pouring, my friend.
Let's do it. All right.
Are you a vodka person?
I am a vodka person. Actually, should I even say last night?
Oh, yeah. Say it.
Just a vodka and cranberry juice. Okay. No big deal.
Nothing crazy.
But, you know, vodka is the easiest thing to mix drinks with.
Yes.
I mean, you just add a little Coke. Just there add a little is. Whatever. There we go. That should be three.
Perfect. I love it. Next, we got 3 ounces of orange juice. Now, actually, it's technically 6 ounces.
Oh,
so I'm going to do 2 ounces
here. I mean,
we'll
let you drink one, too.
Yes. That's fine. Please. I would love to. Here's another one. And last but not least, our 5th and 6th ounce of orange juice.
This seems like it's going to be a really nice summer drink.
Yes, it is. This is exactly why we're doing it in the summer. See, summer citrus. It is what it is. We're here in Phoenix. The sun is just one today.
That's right.
By the way.
That's right.
I just wanted to shout that out real quick here. 2 ounces cranberry juice. You can substitute pomegranate if you'd like to.
Ooh, that would be good.
However, today... Well, we're going with the cran.
The next time I make the drink, I'll try pomegranate and let you know.
Try a little pomegranate and let us know how it goes. Okay, so I think that's it for the liquids. Now, this is definitely you right here.
Oh.
Did you ever bartend at any point in your life?
No.
Okay, cool. Then you probably don't have any technique, but that's okay.
I don't.
Just like a little here, a little there. Everyone's kind of got their own like...
Just, you know...
Yeah.
I think I did it right. This is so nice, though.
Yeah, not bad.
What's the shake thing? The shaker thing? Oh, that's embarrassing. I keep wanting to hear ice, but there's no ice
there's
in it.
No
the
ice is
already in the glass. You think that's enough?
Here. Yeah, that should be plenty. That should be plenty.
Nice.
Now we mix it up right in here. Ooh, wow.
Is it going to be equal? You're taking more for you.
No, I'm just trying to make sure it's even, because sometimes I think when Mo was here, I underpoured myself, so can't have that happen.
No, of course not.
Perfect. Okay,
that's
close to even as it'll get.
I think so.
All right. Now we need to garnish.
So grab
an orange.
All right.
Kind of stick it in there.
Make it look all fancy.
Yup.
Ish.
A citrus sunrise beverage.
Cheers, y'all.
Courtesy of Ciroc.
Yes. Boom.
Let's give it a try.
All right.
Not half bad.
All right.
I will say, not half bad.
It is. It's good. It's very, it's light.
It is light.
I mean, you know, hence a summery drink.
Yes.
That's something
perfect
I could see myself, by the pool,
fruity,
sipping drinks.
By the pool. Let us know in the comments what you think.
You guys should definitely try it.
Because that's got great color on it.
It does.
It's just all the way perfect.
You know, blended might work too, like a blended version.
Yeah. Honestly, put it on ice, blend that up, maybe like a summer slushy.
I'm all for that. I'm all
Ciroc
for that.
Needs to hire Danny Cutler to write some recipes for their website.
There we go.
I've never asked you how you got your start in this game.
Oh, my goodness.
So you're a radio DJ with KWS 93.9. Tell the folks just a little bit more about you and how you got to this place.
Well, way back when, in 2007, I was even further back, 2006, I was a podcaster. I had a little political podcast, and it was doing all right. Had lots of followers. It was...
Here in Phoenix, you were?
Yeah, I was here in Phoenix. It wasn't just... It was more of a, you know, just public news and information type thing. So I had a lot of national people who listened in the podcast circuit, but I wanted to syndicate it on radio. And
as you should have.
You know, I was like, why not? I had another friend. He had his podcast syndicated on a little station called KQCX. So I reached out. How about this? Sent it in to the people there. And they said, well, we don't want another talk show. I think it was because it was politically charged, but we won't go there. And they said, but we like your voice. So do you want to do some voice tracking for our station? And I was like, great. No radio experience. I was I knew audio. I produced my own podcast. Right. I, you know, did all the audio editing myself and wrote my scripts and, I mean, whole show. So I knew how to produce a show, but I was doing it all at home. So I'm thinking, great, I'm going to go into the studio. It's going to be great. No, I'm still doing it at home.
There you go.
But I did it with KQCX, and then they merged with KWSS about 6 months later. And I went from midnight overnights to the middays. And that's where I started in 2007. And then from there in 2016, 17 is when I jumped to mornings. And I've been there ever since.
There we go. So, and do you like it there in the morning?
I do. Because honestly, fun little secret radio fact is that we do a little voice tracking on the side. So we're almost live.
It's
like,
you.
Like okay. I call it that. It's almost live. We get everything prepped in advance. Mm-hmm. And then the show rolls out when it needs to, but we're still there and active during the show hours. So. And I can have interviews like this modern audience.
That's right. And so. Neon Dreams, I can bring my coolest, most famous friends. And
there you go. Exactly. I mean, yeah. I'm global now.
Perfect. Exactly. Danny Cutler's show went international.
Exactly.
Just recently.
Thanks
last
to this
year,
modern.
Over a year ago now. God, it feels like yesterday. But
they give me all the credit. They get all the credit.
Now, Danny, you said you got the voice for radio. They're like, we like your voice. What makes a great radio voice? What is it about a voice that makes it a radio voice versus a voice that is not? In your professional scientific opinion.
You know, I don't know, because to be perfectly frank, I'm not a big fan of my voice. I as a vocalist, you might understand going with that.
Oh,
we're
understand.
Kind of our worst critics
when
it comes to those things. So I didn't really know what he meant, but over the years, as I've listened to not just myself, but many, many DJs and just growing up with radio, but you start to tune in to what that could be. And I think it's just a personable voice. So somebody that can just sit and make you feel like the way you and I are talking now, except you're listening to me on the radio. And it's just, you know, I'm chit-chatting one-sided, but the listener feels like they're engaged in the conversation.
Interesting.
So I think that it's not so much a tone of voice or the type of voice. It's more of how that voice connects with the people who are listening.
I like that. Yeah, I don't know. People always say I've got, you know, the voice for music,
I had to catch up
radio,
with you.
Whatever. And oh yeah, you do. So you've interviewed a lot of artists.
I have.
What is the key? So let me backtrack. I'm sure you've had some interviews that didn't go the way you wanted them to. Right? You do any number of interviews and they kind of go sideways. They take a left turn.
A little bit.
What's the key as a professional to keeping your composure in those moments where an interview is just tanking?
So I have been very lucky because number one, I can pre-record my interviews. I don't do a lot of live stuff. So if anything goes south, I can fix it. So there's your little radio secret. Sorry to open
that
box there.
Yeah,
don't tell anybody.
Don't tell anybody.
But at the same time, the things that I've done live, I found that it's more of, can you grab that person who you're interviewing and get them to engage back? Because again, with radio, it's all listening. It's all audio. So you have to be on the ball and make sure they listen. You know, if they're watching it, you can have lulls. You can have little mishaps and stuff because you're watching it visually and it's just a little different. But as soon as somebody hears dead air, they're just like, boop, change station. I'm done. This is ridiculous. So there are people who I've interviewed. You are definitely not one of them who is not, it's hard to get things
something
out of them.
I just go and
you know,
I don't stop.
I always have to edit your interviews way down, Marcus.
That's okay. I'll talk to you.
Where the other guys are just like, we're here too.
Edit them in more. Edit me out because I just take over.
So it's just a matter of preparation on the back end, right? You know, just making sure that I know exactly what I want to ask and I know the details of why I'm interviewing them. Even if it's live, if I'm out there interviewing someone live, why am I doing this? Have a couple facts about them so that way they know what to expect and not ask them something out of the blue. Like, you know, yeah. So what do you think about this happening in the world today? You know, you don't throw any kind of curveballs at them like that.
I think you have a curveball question now.
So. Oh, well, but, you know, so that's, you know, when things are going that way, you also know that you can wrap it up really quickly, too. So it's like, okay, we're going back to the music now or whatever. So you just, I think it's the interviewer who needs to time that and learn those cues so they know I can take this further or
you should
it's time
just
to cut
switch it.
It
over.
Yeah, but it'll still sound great when the listener is hearing
Absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. It always will because we're professionals. Now, let me ask you this.
I think I mean one of these probably.
Yeah. Go for it. Go because I take left turns. I take a question here.
I'm ready.
Then I go right over here.
I'm ready.
During quarantine.
Oh.
What? So you were still doing your thing. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you're working from home anyways. Mm-hmm. What were you binging, though? Are you a movie watcher?
Are you
a game player? What is Danny Cutler peek behind the curtain? What are we doing like in our
it
free time?
It is movies and TV shows. I'm probably the biggest Netflix streamer. If you like saw stats on people, it'd be like...
Netflix number one.
Yeah, you know, in the top five, probably.
Definitely,
and quarantine was rough because, obviously, as everybody knows, we were... in.
Yeah.
We couldn't go out as much.
The
Even when
time.
Things started opening back up, it was still very slow mm-hmm. going. So I found myself going to comfort things. So movies and TV shows that I've watched or saw when I was a teenager.
There you go.
And I'm a little more removed from the teen years than say you are.
I
so
doubt it.
A lot of 80s movies were in my playlist. And I just, you know, that was comforting to me because everything was so unknown. Didn't know it was happening. I missed my community
Absolutely.
So much.
The music community, the local music community.
You know, that is my out. That is my release. That is my community. I live with somebody who's very introverted. So that's how we make it work.
Yeah.
So having that taken away from me for so long was, you know, it was rough. It was rough for a while. But 80s movies.
80s movies.
Yeah, just 80s movies. And of course, my back always to Supernatural, which is not an 80s show, but that's my go-to all the time.
You've been a champion of the local music scene. Why local music? What is it about the local scene specifically that makes you want to support it and come in so clutch like you always do?
For me, I have always been about the underdog. I look back through my life and all of the things I've done, even jobs I've held, and it has always just been a sense of how do I bring this community together? Even when I worked for a debtor attorney doing bankruptcies,
wow.
You know, that was like one of my first jobs, early 90s. And I realized that I was helping people, you know,
sometimes
they were, you know, a little bit scammy on
sure,
those things, but
sure.
Overall they had real problems
and
they really needed help.
Yeah.
So that is just something that's always been instilled with me. You know, the volunteer work I do with foster children. I mean, I just want to help. So the local music scene is just, it's community that I want to help rise up. We have so much good talent
we
in
sure
the
do.
Valley, in the state. So much. I mean, just independent music in general, whether they are with independent labels or no labels, they deserve a chance to be heard. Their music deserves a chance to be heard. And it brings me so much joy to be able to play their music on the radio, give them play.
That moment is big for people.
It really is.
It was huge for us, that's for sure.
It is. I get, when I do my 9:39 local spotlight in the mornings, they tune in, they get their family, their friends to tune in or stream.
Yeah.
And, you know, I get so much great comments and feedback. They're just so excited that they get this radio play. And that
otherwise
is something I would just like to say that this is something that you won't get that reaction from being streamed on Spotify. It's great to get streams on Spotify. I'm not cutting out Spotify because it's very important for musicians. But the reaction you get to hear that live or even get into radio rotation, which you can do with KWSS. You know, we have local music, mainstream music, all of it mixed together.
Yeah.
So every now and then I'll get a text or a message from a musician going, I just heard me on the radio. Or they post a photo on Instagram saying, oh my gosh,
we're on
KWSS right
sure.
now. And
I've
it's unplanned there. Because that's how you listen to radio. You know, you're just listening. And then a song comes on and you're like, what?
Yep.
So
I heard Next Time Around in rotation with a couple of good friends of mine in town from LA.
Mm-hmm.
And we were just in the car driving. I turned on the station in particular because I figured it might come on.
Yep.
And it came on and I got to have this moment.
Isn't
of like,
that great?
You guys are in town. Check out what's playing on our local radio.
Well, and to
right
talk
now,
about like, Neon Dreams again really quick. I mean,
shout out.
Thanks. Yes. Miss them so much. They just
time.
Had a stream this past weekend.
They've been killing me out in South Africa. I only wish I could have been
there. That would have been great.
Cheers.
So you introduced me to them.
Mm-hmm.
and had them on the show. That was one of the last interviews before everything shut down. But because of that, I know them now. So we're able to have their songs in our rotation. So exactly. I think it's House Party that is
playing
in rotation.
Right,
yeah, that's in rotation. You can request it. It's, yeah. So that's
I
how
still
this,
have a theory that that song is about us.
It probably
just
is.
Just saying.
You know, I can see that being about you. Definitely.
Yeah, I honestly think it is.
But that's the thing, is just you provide that opportunity to people that will not have that opportunity in other places. I have always just been a music lover, too. I mean, you know, of course, growing up and just loving the radio and loving music and loving all of that. But then, you know, I was raised with classical music, so brought up, you know, obviously a different genre than what we play on KWSS, but I've always had this love of music. And oh, yeah. I love, you know, I play viola and I love playing it still. And
you play your viola pretty regularly?
I do. I am actually now recorded with a local band.
Wow.
Yeah,
keep that in mind, because sometimes we think
so,
of things like that. We've had people play instruments like that. Okay.
Shout out to Scattered Melodies.
Shout out to Scattered Melodies.
They are a duo and they bring in local artists from around the valley for their albums. And on
cool.
their last album called Patterns, ding, I am playing viola on the last three tracks of the album.
Wow.
And I started going and doing live shows with them. So I've been on stage. I mean, this,
that is awesome. That is something that I did not know. Shout out to
just,
Scattered Melodies. Let's get in touch. Scattered
yes,
Melodies.
Yes. It's just, but that's the beauty of this community,
yeah,
is that
yeah.
I wasn't looking for it. It just happened. And Josh remembered, and Josh and Scattered Melodies remembered that I said I played viola and they were looking for strings.
They pulled you in.
Do you want to come in? And, you know, it just created that experience. And these are the kinds of things that supporting this scene can do, all the connections you can make.
Absolutely.
And all the music still left to make.
What's next for Danny Cutler?
What is next? Well, at the time of this, us being here, things are now pretty open.
Getting back. Almost there.
Yeah, you know,
almost there.
Yeah. So things are open. I went and got my two shots done. Mm-hmm. Not any of these shots here. But
me too, right here.
I'm really sad
that
Tim's not going to come and take a shot at the end of this.
I actually am. Sean can, though.
Okay,
Sean,
good.
Absolutely,
we'll get Sean
can.
To do it.
Absolutely.
So,
you just got to get a little shot glass for him or something. I got one.
So now that things are opening up again and the venues are open, got vaccinated. I've finally been to a couple of live shows and just cried.
It was a beautiful thing, I'm
it
sure.
It was really beautiful. Not just because I was connecting with music again, but connecting with that community that I haven't really seen other than Zoom interviews for over a year.
Which only take you so far.
It really does. It was a nice substitute, but
I haven't got to give Danny a hug in over a year.
We
got to hug back then.
That's
it was
the thing. I hug people and I tell them I'm sorry I'm over hugging.
Yeah,
you know,
it's
I,
okay.
I apologize. Or they try and let you know, I'm like, no.
Yeah,
no.
Don't let go. No, this is not over yet.
So yeah, it's been a little awkward probably for everybody out there who's seeing me again. But that's okay. But it's been good. So what's next is getting KWSS moving again, because yes, during the pandemic, we're also a 501c3 nonprofit. So we support arts, entertainment, mm-hmm. local music, small business here in the Valley, and we work on sponsorships. So that kind of took a dive
Guaranteed.
Over quarantine, especially with the lack of live music because nobody's promoting anything. So that is my big next step, is getting back in that game, getting more sponsorship, getting more people involved with the station again, and getting out there again more.
Back
our
out
tent
the community.
And
yeah,
yeah just
yeah.
just showing that, you know, we never left. We've always been here, but now we can be out with you again.
Brand visibility.
Absolutely.
That's, one.
That's how it goes.
Where can people
brand
find you,
visibility.
Danny? where yeah, right here. Where can people find you? And where can people find KWSS?
Yes. So for me, you know, I overshare. So if you want to stalk me anywhere on the internet, it is D Cutler AZ, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, wherever. Even on TikTok, though, I don't do a lot of TikToks.
We connected on TikTok.
We did.
After you follow Happy Hour with Marcus
yes,
on TikTok.
Yes, we did. So I mostly am a voyeur there. I don't really do it, other than my dog
yeah,
videos. But
I was gonna say,
I know.
That's what I'm best for on that app. So.
So yeah, and KWSS, it's KWSS Radio everywhere online or KWSS.org. And yeah, definitely take a listen. We're a low power FM station. So in the Phoenix and west side of the valley, we come in great. The East Valley, you should stream. So tune in app or through kwss.org.
I always do it straight from the website. It works fantastic. Nice. Download the app, catch it wherever you can. Danny, thank you so much for being here with us.
Thank you for having me. This is fun. Yeah. I got to finish my... You already poured yourself a second.
Yeah, I'm already on my second. And it was like a lazily put together one. I just kind of did
what I was
going
to say, there's a little more vodka
it.
In there, I think.
Yeah, probably. Sean, come on down. I got for you a shot. Sean hates vodka. Normally it's Tim. Tim is on a hike. We love you, buddy. We hope you're having a great hike.
So I'm Tim today. I'm shooting today's episode.
Yep. Yep. Cameraman Sean behind the scenes. Thank you for being here. Danny, thank you all so much. Cheers.
Cheers.
We'll see you for the next episode or next season. I think this is the end of the season. Ah. This is the end of the season. Woo! Cheers. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'm not going there.
That's okay.